So the ASUS Zenfone Flip is currently the only phone which has a generation of the flip-top cameras and stuck with this concept throughout the years. But the question is this just a gimmick to get people to buy the phone? And how does the phone perform when it comes to using it from a day-to-day basis? Well, let's find out. Now, starting from the unboxing, the box comes in a nice grey coloured box with the number 8 in the middle and ASUS Zenfone 8 Flip down below. Opening the box, you'll find another smaller box which says Defy Ordinary on the outside, where you'll find the SIM ejector pin, the user manual and a rather high quality hard clamp shell case, which is nice to know, so good job ASUS. Below that, you'll find the USB-C to USB-C cable and a 30 watt charging brick. Now look at the phone specs. The ASUS Zenfone 8 Flip comes with the Snapdragon 888 chipset, which has the 860 5G modem. Then it has the Adreno 660 GPU, and the variant that I have is the 8GB of RAM with 256GB of UFS 3.1 storage, and it comes shipped with Android 11, where during my review period, it comes with Zen UI version 8 of 30.11. Next, look at the phone's build quality at the back. It has a 3D curved Corning Gorilla Glass, and because it is curved, it makes the phone feel great to hold. And since the phone had a quiet weight to it, since it is packed with a hold mechanism and a large battery in the phone, the overall matte finish on the frame made it feel great in the hands and also had a very premium design. And the type of finish that I have is called the Galactic Black, and it also comes in Glacier Silver, where both phones has a gradient finish. And as y'all would already know that the cameras have a flip mechanism, that is why it's called the Zenfone 8 Flip, where when the cameras are folded, it is right in the center towards the top of the phone with a medium-sized camera bump. And because the camera bump is right in the middle, you won't have any issues when it comes to typing the phone on the surface where it didn't wobble at all. And speaking of the flip mechanism, I do like the overall concept of it. And when it comes to the build quality of the camera, it does seem to move easily when it's flipped, so it's not too rigid, which means that you can get a bit more creative in your shots, and it also does change the orientation as well. And according to ASUS, this flip mechanism can last up to 300,000 flips. But to be honest, I'm very sure it could survive even more, because remember how everyone was very worried about the pop-up camera? Well, knowing ASUS, I don't think there will be any issues with the flip-out mechanism. And finally, there's the fall detection feature, where if the phone detects that the camera is falling or the phone is falling, it will automatically flip the camera to ensure that the camera mechanism won't be damaged. Then below the camera arrays, you'll find a tiny little microphone over there, which is a directional microphone that is used when recording videos, where it will record according to the direction of the subject, whether or not you're recording it from the back, side, or even the front, which works more of a 3D audio recording, which was quite neat. Then looking at the phone's ports and buttons, looking down below, other than the USB-C port, you'll find one of the two stereo speakers over there, where the other speaker is at the earpiece area. And looking towards the left, at the bottom of the phone, you'll find a notification LED. And on the right, there's a power button, which is available in blue, which was quite a nice touch from ASUS. And this button could be remapped for actions like double pressing or even pressing and holding commands. And of course above, you'll find your volume rockers. Then finally on the left, there's the dual SIM and the micro SD card slot. Next, looking at the phone's display, it comes with a 6.67 inch full screen nano edge display with an AMOLED panel, and it has a resolution of 1080 by 2400 pixels together with a 90Hz refresh rate, where you can either change to leave it at auto or manually select it to 90Hz or even 60Hz. And on top of that, the phone has 1000 nits of peak brightness and HDR10+, and since the phone is an AMOLED panel, other than the always on display, it has an in-display fingerprint sensor where it does unlock decently quick, even with the unlocking animation on the phone. Now, if you've been following my channel for quite a while, you would know that I absolutely love a full screen or a full view screen display without any hole punch at the screen area. As you guys can see, with a 92% screen to body ratio, the visual experience when watching videos on YouTube and Netflix was really nice, with great color reproduction and also nice contrast as well. Alright, now let's take a look at the flipping cameras. That sounded like I was cursing, but I was not. Now the phone has a 64 megapixel Sony IMX686 sensor with an aperture value of f1.8, 26mm lens, and 8 megapixel f2.4 telephoto lens with up to 3 times optical zoom, and finally a 12 megapixel f2.2 aperture 14mm ultra wide angle lens. Now overall I have to say that I was very impressed with the image processing on the phone. Where starting with the ultra wide angle shots, the focal length was really good with a lot of cover in the shots, with extremely less on the barrel distortion for the sides, and the overall colors looked really pleasing and very true to life. Then the main camera shots had a very consistent colors with no color shift from the ultra wide angle lens compared to some of the other phones that I've seen within this price range, with amazing dynamic range and a very sharp images. Now the dynamic range was so good that I intentionally shot against the sunlight, and yes, I still could capture images without any overexposure issues. Now since there is a dedicated 3x telephoto lens, you'll find the images to not only be consistent in colors but also very nicely detailed. Now if you guys are shooting objects, I wouldn't recommend using the portrait mode to get the nice subject focus to background blur, as I think it's better to use the main lens and get closer to the subject to get a better shallow depth of field with amazing details. Then as for the night mode, it has two exposure options for either 4 seconds or 6 seconds with a slight difference in exposure timing for the ultra wide angle lens, where the ultra wide shots look great during the night, but I really love the pictures more on the main lens. Then as for selfie, since you can just flip out the camera like this, this guys is hands down the best selfie camera that I've seen on any smartphone out right now, where not only the dynamic range was extremely great, but the colors and the sharpness was just superb. Then the same could be said for the selfie portrait mode, as the results were amazing with the best subject to background blur. Then I test out taking selfies at night, since the main lens could be flipped once again, and the amount of coverage that I could get not only for the main lens but the ultra wide angle lens was really great too. Now as for video, the phone records up to a massive 8K 7680 by 4320 pixels, and the 8K footage is currently also the best that I've seen, with amazing image stabilization and extreme amount of details. And there wasn't a point of time that the camera overheated and stopped recording like how it was consistently on the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra or even the OnePlus 9. And since the camera is once again flippable, I know I've mentioned flippable so many times, since it's a flippable camera phone, you can actually record selfie videos with that huge overkill of an 8K resolution. Overkill, but I think that is brilliant. And what's extra sweet is that you can actually upload the 8K footage on Instagram stories, which is something that other phones like the Samsung, Xiaomi, and also the OnePlus 8K footage couldn't do on Instagram, so... damn. Now as for the phone's audio, here's where I have to applaud ASUS once again for taking the audio department a bit seriously compared to many smartphones within this price range. Where not only the speakers had great audio quality but nice audio separation and very pronounced mids and a decent amount of bass, with output of 91.7 dB. While it's not the loudest compared to other flagship smartphones, but it had a very good sound quality. And what's sweet is there is also the ASUS audio wizard, where there are pre-installed audio modes like dynamic mode to boost the overall audio quality, music mode for listening to music, cinema mode for movie watching, and game mode as well. And here is a quick sound test for all. Now taking a look at the phone's software, the ASUS Zenfone 8 Flip comes with Zen UI version 8 on top of Android 11. Now, as mentioned that during this review, it was based on the UI being updated to version 30.11. Now, this is my very first time that I'm experiencing the Zen UI and also reviewing an ASUS phone. So I have to say that I absolutely had no complaints when it comes to the overall navigating from a day-to-day basis. And everything was pretty fluid with easy and also stock Android-like experience with a 200Hz touch sampling rate. Now, I did notice that Instagram tends to slightly compress the images if you upload photos on Instagram stories. And also adding the music functions or the Instagram reels on the Instagram stories is not available. But of course, we need to blame IG for this and not ASUS. And speaking of Instagram stories, if you guys are a regular user of Instagram stories like me, where the flipping camera hit my hand for a few times because I'm used to holding a phone with two hands, not usually with just one hand, just in case I drop the phone. But of course, that is more of a user error. But other than that, there's no issues when using this phone daily. And one thing worth mentioning is the fact that the phone never had any overheating issues compared to something like the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra or even the OnePlus 9 as mentioned earlier. So for those of you who said it is because of the Snapdragon 888 processor, well, for this phone, it's definitely not the case. Then finally, when it comes to the animation speeds, it could be controlled easily and the UI is more customizable, where you are able to change the font, accent colors and the icon shapes. And according to ASUS, there'll be at least two major OS updates for the phone, so that was great to know. Now onto the phone's battery, the ASUS Zenfone 8 Flip comes with 5000 mAh of battery, and that was one of the reasons why the phone had a thicker and a heavier form factor. Now, I did a screen on time battery based on two scenarios of refresh rate, where based on the refresh rate set to auto, I got an average of 4.5 hours of screen on time when I was at 10% battery with dark mode turned on, and about 4 hours and 20 minutes of screen on time when I set the refresh rate to only 90Hz. So it is just a little different over there. And what's nice is that ASUS have included many battery features such as steady charging that lowers the temperature when charging and of course increasing the lifespan of the battery. Then there's also scheduled charging to keep the phone at a lower percentage overnight where you can set what time it stops charging. And I also loved and appreciated the charging limit feature and the battery care health over on top as well. Now this is a feature which I feel that every other smartphone should include such feature to really extend the lifespan of the battery. Then the phone has fast charging up to 30 watts where the charger is inside of the box as seen earlier, which roughly charges the phone from 0 to 50% about 30 minutes. Then when it comes to the phone's gaming capabilities, I tested out both Genshin Impact, COD Mobile and also PUBG Mobile as well. Now obviously, the phone is not really dedicated for gaming as ASUS has the ROG phones for that. And during my gaming test, if you really take your gaming for a really long time or extend the overall graphics like say overclocking, the adjustments on Genshin Impact, only then the phone gets pretty hot to the touch. Now ASUS have included a feature called Game Genie which is similar to ASUS ROG phones which blocks notification and gives real-time info when you're gaming as well. So in conclusion, to answer the question on how the ASUS Zenfone 8 Flip is, other than the whole flipping camera functions, well, I really have to say that it's been a while since I've been very impressed with the phone, especially for a phone which I never tested out before. Because out of all the smartphones that I've tested within this price range had mediocre performance overall, or there were some compromises on certain areas, well, for this phone, not only the cameras perform really well, and in my opinion, one of the best out right now, especially when it comes to the video recording capabilities, but the overall battery life was also decent and using the phone from a day-to-day basis was quite a breeze as well, and is surely a phone that I would totally recommend, especially coming with a price of only 2,999 ringgit. So with this, I have to really tip off my hat to ASUS for sticking with this flipping camera technology instead of stopping such features like how when Samsung introduced the Galaxy A80 2 years ago. So with this, do let me know what you guys think of the ASUS Zenfone 8 Flip, and would you guys get it? Do let me know at the comment section below. Aside from that, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys found this video helpful in making your purchase decision. If you did, be sure to give this video a nice big thumbs up. That would be very much appreciated. My name is Adam Lobo, and I'll catch you guys in my next video.